Well, the Reserve Bank has declared Australia is on track to bring inflation under control, with higher interest rates allowing the central bank to hold rates at 4.1% for a second straight month. While the Treasurer has welcomed the pause, he's warned the fight is not over. Australians are still under the pump, especially with the threat of future hikes still looming. Let's bring in Home Affairs Minister Clare O'Neill and Shadow Finance Minister Jane Hume. Good morning, Clare. The Treasurer has ruled out introducing any new cost of living measures. Is this the best approach when we see that the average New South Wales mortgage has gone up $1,600 since rates have been increasing? That is enormous.
Yeah, absolutely, Nat. And, you know, we saw the Reserve Bank put interest rates on hold for the second month running yesterday, and that is really welcome relief, I know, for households right across Australia. It's a really good thing for the country. That doesn't make the pain go away, and I can tell you that the Albanese government's first, second and third priority is helping our households manage the cost of living. That's why you saw that unprecedented $13.6 billion investment in the budget, cheaper medicines, assistance with energy prices, cheaper childcare, which will make a really significant difference to people. But look, we are always trying to find ways to ease the pressure on households, and we'll continue to do that as we go forward. We've done a lot about this problem, and we're listening to the Australian people who are telling us this is the main problem in their lives right now, and that's why we're so focused on it.
Yeah, Jane, the Australian people are also seeing some of that being eaten away in childcare, in the electricity sector. Do you think now that the Treasurer has a much bigger surplus than he anticipated, that he should be doing more to take the pressure off the people who are suffering here?
Well, let's face it, Nat, when Anthony Albanese promised the Australian people prior to the election that their mortgages were going to be cheaper, that their childcare was going to be cheaper, that their energy bills were going to be cheaper, that is patently false. We've actually seen 11 interest rate rises under this Labor government, and more pain is on the way because inflation is still twice what it should be, what that target band for the RBA is. The government keeps saying that getting inflation under control is its number one priority, and yet everything it does seems to move in the opposite direction. It's still spending more than it ever has before, about $187 billion more than just 18 months ago. So, you know, let's face it,
Finder, I think it was, said just this week,
they said, Finder said that 40% of Australian mortgage holders struggled to pay their bills last month, struggled to pay their mortgage. So, of course, they must do more to get inflation under control. The way to do that is to rein in your spending ambitions, not spend more, and yet that's exactly what they're doing.
So they shouldn't help people, Jane. Is that what you're saying? They shouldn't spend more and put more money into the economy?
Well, putting more money into the economy could potentially make the inflation genie worse.
Exactly.
And we know that that's the case.
So what are you suggesting the government does, Jane?
Well, the government should be reining in its spending ambitions, and yet it seems to be spending more and more. Every single thing that comes through the Senate seems to have an enormous price tag attached to it. This is a government that's having an expansionary budget, not a contractionary budget,
which means that the RBA keeps having to put its foot on the accelerator. I'm so confused, Jane.
While the government should be putting its foot on the brake, but it's not.
And it doesn't make any sense. I'm hearing Jane say two completely contradictory things, Claire, and that's the problem.
I actually think you're not listening to the Australian people.
You need to bring inflation under control. You can't just talk about it. You have to actually do it. And your budget hasn't done that. It's done the opposite.
That's why we've...
Now, you asked a really good question before about the budget surplus, and let me just quickly explain that to people because it is really important. This is the first budget surplus that we have had in this country in 15 years. We are responsible managers of the budget. It is very important that we don't actually spend too much in the budget because that will drive inflation, and inflation is the main problem that is driving all of the cost of living agony that people are living through right now. So what you're seeing from the government is a really clear, consistent balance, lots of cost of living relief, as much as we can afford, but at the same time, responsible budget management so we don't make this inflation problem a lot worse. I think we're getting the balance right.
Okay, the big problem in this country that everyone is talking about as well is housing. Anthony Albanese will reintroduce Labor's flagship housing bill to Parliament for a second time today that aims to build 30,000 homes over 5 years, but the legislation has already been knocked back by the Greens and the Coalition. If it fails to pass again, that could trigger an early election, probably a year early. Claire, is that what Albo's trying to do?
Not at all, Nat. What we're trying to do is build more housing for Australians. And I really want the Liberals and the Greens to get the message here. Australians are living through a really problematic housing crisis. The Labor government is trying to build more houses and they are blocking us and stopping us from doing this. Now, this is a $10 billion package that is in the Parliament at the moment. 30,000 homes over 5 years that will house people who are at risk of long-term homelessness, women and children who are fleeing domestic violence, veterans, war veterans who have served their country but are struggling to find housing when they get home to Australia. We want to build homes for these people, and the Liberals and the Greens are conspiring to stop us. And if you're listening to this and you are as outraged as I am, contact your Liberal senators. Tell them to get with the program. We have got a housing problem in this country. The government is trying to do something about it, and the Liberals and the Greens need to get out of the way so we can get on with the job of fixing this.
Jane,
oh, Claire, you're borrowing $10 billion. You're borrowing, no, the Labor government are trying to borrow $10 billion in Australians' name, which is going to come with an interest rate price tag of about $400 million a year, plus a management fee of around $100 million a year. So it's going to cost about $500 million a year just to repay. Then they're going to invest that with the Future Fund, and it's only the returns on that money that will be invested in housing. So there is no guarantee that there will be even one single house built. Not one.
Oh,
not
that's
one.
Ridiculous.
Not a guarantee
that's
for even
completely
one.
Ridiculous.
And yet it's going to cost you about $500 million a year just to maintain.
Ridiculous.
They're borrowing in your name with no guarantee of a single house being
Claire,
built.
Claire, are you doing
that's
this
not
on
good
borrowed
policy,
money?
And that's
is
why
that
we're
the
borrowing
problem?
It.
Nat, that is absolutely ridiculous. What we are
it
talking about here is investing $10 billion to build 30,000 homes over 5 years.
Borrowing $10 billion,
Jane and her
borrowing
colleagues
it.
Can put themselves through all sorts of verbal gymnastics about what this is and what this isn't. Let me just lay it out clearly. The Labor
You're
government wants to build
Australian
more homes.
People, Claire,
the Liberals
are
stopping us.
Money.
We need them to work with us to try to address this problem in the interests of our constituents. Get with the program,
okay,
Jane. This is a real problem
well,
for the country.
Well, it doesn't sound like you're going to come to an agreement anytime soon, and that is what the problem is with the double dissolution election. The vote won't be till October, so you guys can smoke a peace pipe maybe before then. We'll talk soon. Thank you very much.